So to learn more about the different sections of Xcode, I went up to help and then clicked on documentation and started typing in Xcode overview. And the resulting help page provided a lot of good detail, including what the names of these different sections within Xcode are actually called. By the way, an online version of this document is also available in the instructor notes. Now, if I go back to my Xcode project, we can see that Xcode is divided into three main sections: the navigator on the left, the editor in the middle of the screen, and the utility on the right. Now, the navigator, as the name suggests, allows us to browse through files. Here you can see that we are making this app for iOS 8. We are building this on iPhone, and the device orientation of the phone is portrait, landscape left, and landscape right. For the sake of simplicity, however, I will only choose portrait as the device orientation. Xcode created a few files for us by default, one of which is called viewcontroller.swift. Let's check this one out. By the way, this code may be a little bit too small for you to read, so let me make it a little bit bigger. That's much better. Notice that this file says that it was created by Udacity. Now, this for you is probably the name that you entered under organization while you were making this app. We are going to begin to write code in this file in just a few minutes. For now, I will click on main.storyboard in the navigator. Now, you will notice that Xcode likes a lot of real estate, and these three buttons here at the top right are very helpful with managing that real estate. For instance, this button helps us show and hide the navigator. This button right next to it helps us show and hide the debug area, and this is the place where you actually see error messages. And the final button here will show and hide utilities. Okay, back to the main.storyboard. Here is where we will actually draw the things that our user will see on the app. It is empty for now, but by the time we are done making this app, this is what the storyboard will look like. These storyboards can get really elaborate. For instance, here is a screenshot of what the storyboard for the Udacity iPhone app looks like. Now, one thing to notice here is that this box on your screen almost looks like a square. If you've done some work with Objective-C, another language which is used to make iPhone apps, you will notice that this is new. We can change the way this box looks by changing the width and height settings here at the bottom of the screen. They currently say any, which means that this layout works for both iPhones and iPads. Since I'm making this app for the iPhone, I can change the layout here. Great, this looks a little bit more like the phone. Now, Xcode has a lot of other helpful features that we will explore while making our app. For instance, we will talk about these buttons on the left, the cluster of these three buttons here on the right, and if I pull out the utility area, we'll also talk about these buttons here. If you're curious about any of these buttons right now, you can look at the handout that we have provided in the instructor notes. Before I end this tour, I have a challenge for you. I want you to explore Xcode and see if you can figure out a way to run the current version of our app in a simulator inside your computer. Once you're done with that, I want you to see if you can figure out how to check the CPU and memory usage for our app. As a quick hint, the answer is somewhere in the documentation listed in the instructor notes.